Hi, welcome back to ODE YouTube channel. My name is Paulo and today I'm here for another pen review. And today I'm going to show you this pen, the Furore Grande, which means it is a Leonardo Officina Italiana. And it is a very nice pen. So let's take a look inside. This pen arrives in this box that has interesting ceramics printed on the outer sleeve of the box, and when I looked at it, these remind me of the Portuguese very well-known tiles from 17th and 18th century, and so I asked the people from Leonardo, and they told me these were the traditional tiles from the Amalfi Coast in Italy. So this pen was sent to me by Salvatore Matrone from Leonardo Officina Italiana. He sent me this pen for review. It says here, fatto a mano in Italia, which means handmade in Italy, and then more than 45 years of experience from father to son, and the story goes on. On the back of that, on the bottom, it has this blue and white, also quite characteristic here in Portugal, so it's fun. And so we have here inside the Leonardo Furore Grande pen. Let's take the box, the sleeve away, and then we have a black box made of cardboard with the Leonardo Officina Italiana and the logo, which are those wings engraved, printed. Then you take out another black box, and this is really the case. It has this kind of fake leather finish, like a vinyl finish, which is interesting. And we open this and we have on the inside of the lid Leonardo Officina Italiana again and the logo. And here we have a booklet with the Furore Grande Pistone, which explains the origin of the name. It is on a fjord in Italy. And the origin of Furore, which is the name of that fjord, and so on. You can have interesting information here. Then you have the warranty of the pen. And these pens come in the same kind of package as the Momento Zero Grande, which are these kind of packages with a slot for the pen and with a slot for an ink bottle. This time he sent me this one. I think this can change. It's not the same color that comes with the pen. He sent me the blue ink from Leonardo. And this blue ink, just for like a preview, you have it here. It is a very nice blue with some kind of a pinkish sheen on the edges of where it is wetter. But the review of the ink will come soon, someday. And now let's take the pen out and put the box away and let's see. So, with this close-up on the pen, let's take a look at it. It is the typical cigar-shaped pen, and I would say this is a very nice and interesting pen. So, I told you about the shape. It's that cigar shape. However, some people call it torpedo. I'm not sure. It's this traditional shape you can see in many pens. And you have a clip that is fixed to the cap with no ring. It is very springy and it has this little wheel to allow the fabric of your pocket or pouch or anything to go beneath it and slide well. It has two cap rings and then it has a ring there that is actually in the barrel. And then you have a ring on the barrel that separates the barrel itself from the turning knob for the piston. Yes, because this is a piston filler. And there is nothing more to see about the exterior part. Then you have also the engraving here that shows you Leonardo, Officina Italiana, and then the serial number of the pen. It is not a limited edition, it is a regular edition, but Leonardo numbers the pens. This was not aligned with the clip, but it is not a problem of the pen, of course. You can just rotate the cap again. It has three different entries to the threads, so one of them will align perfectly the engraving on the barrel with the clip, and it gets nice. Then you unscrew the pen, and for unscrewing it you have one turn and one quarter. The engraving on the barrel also aligns with the nib. The nib, you can see here, is a steel nib with Leonardo, Italy, and then the F for fine nib. It is a steel, silver colored, and then you have an ebonite feed. And as time goes by, the more I use pens with ebonite feeds, the more I think it is much more important than the feed. But that's another discussion for some other day. This pen has a ring there, or a band, between the section and the nib. Some people are a little bit afraid of these, because in some pens these may corrode, and I've seen that, although I've not seen that in Leonardo pens. And Salvatore told me that this is made of stainless steel, so it will not corrode. And I have to believe him so far, because my Momento Zero Grande may be a little dirty there, but no corrosion at all. And it is gold plated, so it is more prone to do that, I would guess. The section is glued to the barrel, so do not try to dismantle this, and this operates the piston. This is it for the pen. Just another detail, it has this, I would say, unusual shape, but it is the regular shape for Leonardo, so it's not that strange. It is strangely comfortable to hold, because you try to find, at least I do, somewhere between the thinner part and the widest part, I try to find a place where I like to rest my index finger here on the thinnest part, and I like to hold my thumb a little bit back there, almost over the threads, and I find this very comfortable. So, but this works for me, it's not the same for everyone, but I've not seen anyone saying that these pens are not comfortable to hold. So the nib is a number 6 nib. I don't remember if I told you about that, and here it is. This pen has no ink window, so you cannot see the ink level. It has a very large ink capacity of 1.5 milliliters of ink, and it is the same ink capacity of the Leonardo Momento Zero Grande. This one is the sand. Also the Pistone version, which is a real, let's call it real piston, that has the same we can say they are the same pens, it's just the preference of the design. The Furore Grande is called Furore Grande because before of the Furore being released, there was the Furore Grande being released, there was the Furore, the regular size. This pen is smaller, it has the same overall design, the clip is thicker than this one. When you uncap the pen, you see the same kind of nib, the same size, not the band there. And this one is a cartridge converter pen that you unscrew this, and you can use it like this, unscrewing, or you can use it by taking out this blind cap and using that way. So they made this pen, and now they increase the size and you have the furore grande. However, unlike what happened with the Momento Zero, they didn't go through this, I would say, in-between model, which is the previous Momento Zero Grande, which had this piston filling system. There are people that say this is a captive converter. I will not call that. I think in these pens, this is a piston filler, in any case, because it is fixed, so it is a piston filler. This is my opinion only. And so I will consider the whole barrel to be a huge blind cap. Let's call it that way. I have other pens, more vintage, that also has this design. So this is interesting. So when they had the Momento Zero, they changed to this version to be the Grande. And then they changed to that one, which is a pistone like that one. Usually, Leonardo, this is the Dark Hawaii, by the way. Usually, Leonardo makes this very beautiful, very chatoyant, is this a word? Resins that have lots of depth and they are very, very beautiful. However, when Salvatore asked me which pen would I like to have for review, I chose this one, and maybe for two main reasons. First, because there are already some reviews of another version of this pen, which is Esmeraldo, which is emerald. It's a very beautiful material that is has some chatoyants, very similar to this one, but in a green, bluish green color, not a red one. It is very beautiful. And there are already lots of them. And I found, and I thought that for having more plain resin, it would be nice to see how the pen looks. And what I have to say is that this model is stunning. This material, there is no or almost no chatoyance in this material. But this really reminds me of the sea hitting the rocks next to a big cliff, and then this swirls is the foam that is created by the waves. I think this pen is a beautiful pen. I have to say, though, that I prefer the design of the Momento Zero better than the Furore. Okay, we are taking already a long time, but when I talk about pens that I like, it's harder to make short videos. So, this is the Furore Grande. Let me show you some other pens that have the same kind of design. And one of those that I remember immediately is this one. This is the Montblanc 149. And when I heard that Leonardo was going to make a Furore Grande, I thought, maybe that's not a good idea, because if they are doing this pen bigger with a smaller nib than Montblanc, it will not look that great. It will have some comparisons and maybe people will complain, will start comparing. What I found, and I was thinking already about this, so I have to say that I was biased that way, but when I looked at it, I thought that they are not really comparable. The shape is quite different, and I think the lack of that ring here that holds the clip makes all the difference. So I don't think of Montblanc, and I do not compare the nib sizes. And additionally, Leonardo also has a version of this pen with gold nib, and that gold nib is a number 8 nib, so the nib is almost the same size of the Montblanc. So if you want to pay an extra price, you can also have a big pen with a bigger nib. So there was really nothing to be afraid of when I thought about the comparisons with the Montblanc. However, I have to say they are all in the same style. I cannot fit them this way on the frame. Let's put the Leonardo Furore Grande on the middle, the Montblanc 149, the senator president de Jinhao 159 de Moonman M100 and finally the Sailor King of Pen. So you have here a nice comparison of pens, all of the same overall style, but when you look at the shape of this pen, it's not really comparable with any of those. So it is an interesting thing. This pen is very nice. It is available from several stores. I will leave links below for these pens and the others if you want to check them out. And this pen will cost you around 300 euros with the steel nib. Not very inexpensive, but it has a ebonite feed. It is a piston filler. It is very well made of stunning materials, and there is lots of manual work involved in these pens. So, and it has a very large ink capacity. So it's up to you to choose that. I would say this is a very, very nice pen. And now let's see how it behaves on paper. And here we have the pen and paper. Against the white paper, the colors and the exposure of the camera make it not look so nice, but believe me, this is nice. And when I lift this up to the light, we get to see this material again. I cannot get tired of looking at it, really. I really like this pen and I really like looking at it. Now, something that I didn't tell you, the pen is comfortable to hold. It is very long. You can see it's not a short pen, even if you have big hands, but you can post it. I don't think it comes too back heavy. It is a little bit, but not too much. It still keeps a good balance. But I don't really like to have such a large pen in my hands, so long. So I prefer to use it. I don't know why some people post all the pens. I understand when the pens are small, but I think it is kind of a cultural thing, and some people post every pen. I think it's for avoiding losing the cap. I have, since I was a kid, I was used not to post every pen to avoid scratches on the barrel, and also to hold the cap in my left hand when I write, while I write with my right hand. So let's see how it performs on paper. And this is the Leonardo. Officina Italiana Furore Grande, and this finish, I do not remember if I told you already, it is the Blue Positano. It is available in three other finishes, but for me the Blue Positano is the nicest. Then the ink that I'm using is the Leonardo Blue, a very beautiful ink, and the paper is the usual Rodia.pad. And about the performance of the nib, it writes really well. It had just a little hint of feedback, but a very nice and pleasant one. It's almost unfair to say this is a feedback. It's just enough to know that you are gliding the pen over the paper. And I think this is really, really good. The nib on this pen is a number 6 Bock nib. As far as I was told, Leonardo is changing their Bock nibs to Yovo nibs. There are some complaints about that, but I have to say that the best nibs I ever tried, in my opinion, at least from between these two brands of nibs, are the Bock nibs. They are usually also the nibs that have more problems, such as less quality control, and you may have a pen that is branded M and it is branded extra fine and it is an M. So that may be a problem, but when you have a very good Bock nib, it is really amazing. When you have a good Yovo nib, you always have kind of a good Yovo nib and it is always good. But I think the Bock nibs can be outstanding, and that's my opinion. Now, out of order, something that I didn't show you, just for a moment. The size comparison with the Parker Centennial. I don't know how I forget to do that. Parker Centennial and Lamy Safari. You can see the Leonardo Furore Grande is bigger. And let me just do this quickly, because I should have made this sooner in the review. You have here the Leonardo is bigger with the same kind of nib as the Parker and quite nice sized pen. Okay, let's go back to the review. So the nib, as I told you, it has just a little hint of feedback, a very very nice one. The pen keeps wet for a long time because of the ebonite feed, and it usually doesn't hard start even if it is unkept for a little while. The nib, I would say it is quite rigid. You can try to force it to flex, but it will not really work. And the reverse writing, it is slightly scratchy, but if you really need to make a very small writing, really extra fine, you can do it. It will not get dry, it will keep writing, but it's not pleasant. But the regular writing is perfect, in my opinion. This is a very, very good pen. In terms of wetness, I would say this is not the most wet pen, but it has a fine nib. So for a fine nib, I would say this is really good. And this is good, you know why? Because of the ebonite, also because the nib is well tuned, of course, but also because of the ebonite feed. So what do I think about this pen? I think this pen is really great. Is it worth the 300 euros? If it works for you, it is worth the money. I think it all depends. You can have more, you can have pens that are more inexpensive, but if you really like it, you can have this one. Or if you can afford it, go for it. I really like this pen. I think this is very well made. Although I slightly prefer the shape of the Momento Zero Grande. I think it is more to my personal taste. So this is all for this review. I think this is really nice. I hope you liked the video. I have to thank you. And thank you all. Mr. Salvatore Matrone for sending the pen for review. Thank you all for watching my videos, and keep coming back to my channel to see this stuff that I do with videos, sometimes longer than they should be. So, this is all, and I see you next video. Bye!